Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports frustration turned to elation Thursday as a dizzying legal wrangle ended with same-sex couples receiving marriage licenses in Las Vegas, the marriage capital of the world, and other cities across Nevada. About 10 same-sex couples were standing in line as the announcement came shortly after 5 p.m. The hopes of same-sex couples in Nevada had been in limbo since the Ninth Circuit ruled on Tuesday that same-sex couples' equal protection rights were violated by same-sex wedding bans in Nevada and Idaho. The last challenge opposing Nevada's same-sex marriage was dropped early Thursday, and the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals again declared that its ruling allowed same-sex couples to marry in the state and said it was in full force and effect. Clerks waited for a trial judge to enforce the court's order before they started issuing licenses around 5 p.m. on Thursday. Not long after, Clark County Clerk Diana Alba apologized to about five same-sex couples waiting at the Las Vegas Marriage License Bureau. Meanwhile, same-sex couples in West Virginia began receiving marriage licenses after the state's attorney general dropped his fight opposing same-sex unions. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports the St. Louis area on Thursday was bracing for more unrest over the August killing of Michael Brown by a police officer, and another police killing of a teen on Wednesday was expected to add fuel to the fire. Several civil rights organizations and protest groups, including Hands Up United, planned to mark the weekend with marches and rallies in St. Louis and the suburb of Ferguson, where Brown was killed 2 months ago. The groups are demanding the arrest of the police officer who killed Brown, and they want to draw attention to police treatment of Black Americans. Protest organizers said they are planning only peaceful activities, but fear that Wednesday's killing of a Black teenager in the South St. Louis neighborhood of Shaw might trigger a violent outburst. Tori Russell, the leader of Hands Up United, said, "We never advocate violence, but I do know that people were angry last night and they will be out this weekend. I don't know what they are going to do." At least 6,000 people have registered on an organizing website for the weekend of resistance events in and around Ferguson. Organizers said they are planning to create a memory altar to victims of police violence and to hold a candlelight march carrying a coffin to the Ferguson Police Department. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Shortly after having sexual intercourse with a prostitute earlier this afternoon, local man Jacob Reynolds told reporters that he never expected the experience would bring him to new heights of emotional and spiritual fulfillment.
I was convinced that having sex with a complete stranger behind my wife's back would leave me feeling drained and empty on the inside, but my self-esteem is through the roof.
Reynolds, who said he paid $150 for a 30-minute block of time, said that his moderate expectations for the encounter were instantly surpassed by what turned out to be a deeply personal sexual communion that transported him to a new plane of emotional intimacy.
I've never felt a stronger sense of spiritual connection. When our bodies met, there was an immediate sense of familiarity and comfort that just washed over me. I think it was the most meaningful experience of my life.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you want by dialing in toll free 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Earlier this week, I believe I teased the story about Kim Jong-un, who has sort of disappeared from prominence, from what I understand, over in North Korea, or at least there's some controversy over whether or not he's still in charge of the country. Some are saying that he hasn't been in charge for several months, the bulk of the year, from what I understand.
I've heard nearly a year.
It's Ian and Daryl in the studio here with you tonight. We'll be joined by Ellen here in a little bit. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out in whichever way is best for you. And if you're going to hit us up on Skype, you do need to send a contact request first, which will be ultimately approved. So once again, that's lrn.fm on Skype and toll-free 855-450-FREE. As we will jump into the story here from North Korea, I definitely want to talk about that. And then also, our very own Derek J. Freeman has had a ticket dismissed in court, which is wonderful news. It's the whole idea of not taking the plea deal. We talked about that briefly earlier this week, so we'll share that with you. But let's jump into this. From Vice.com, Daryl, you've got the story.
Yeah, so this article actually came out just a few hours ago, so it is, you know, breaking news of sorts. They write, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has not been seen in public since September 3rd, and today, for the first time, he did not take part in the annual commemoration of the foundation of the Korean Workers' Party. Meanwhile, on October 3rd, three of the highest-ranking officials in the country made a surprise visit to the closing ceremonies of the 2014 Asian Games in Incheon, South Korea, when they agreed with, or rather, where they agreed with South Koreans to resume the inter-Korean dialogue that has been suspended for several years.
So people from North Korea's government actually went to South Korea and talked to folks.
Yes, and they agreed to resume the inter-Korean dialogue.
Amazing.
Right. I mean, so
that sounds like progress to me.
It's been, what, nearly 50 years? There's just been this sort of ceasefire without the official ending of the Korean War.
Yeah, I guess technically they're still at war, right?
Yes,
right.
Technically they are.
There's the always the, you know, the videos of the border crossing zone,
the DMZ,
where the, you know, the North Korean guys are staring down the South Korean guys, and it looks very, very intense.
Well, and they also have three North Koreans for every person on the southern side of the border.
Oh, really?
Because they can't just trust one guy to stand there watching the North Korean border. Because what happens if that guy decides, I don't want to be in North Korea anymore? So they have three. They have, you know, and they create sort of this prisoner's dilemma sort of scenario. So instead of just me and you standing on the border, because we might both agree to, you know, like, hey, let's take off and run. They've got a third person that keeps an eye on both of them. And then they keep an eye on him, and
not exactly the prisoner's dilemma, but I get where you're
right. But
from.
It's that same sort of scenario.
Well, it
to
could
where
also be considered a show of force too, like, oh, we have three times the military that you do. You know, that kind
no,
of
that's not no. the reason.
Okay,
there was a documentary that I had watched several years ago, and they actually explained the reason why there's three on each side and the formation that they have them standing in. You can tell because there's two that are looking directly at one another and past to make sure that, you know, like nobody's trying to sneak south.
Yep.
And then the third one is keeping an eye on both of them and making sure nobody tries to sneak in from South Korea.
Wow.
So the article here continues. It says,
please.
It is strange for Kim to be out of view for this long. While he's avoided public appearances in the past, he's never done so for a whole 5 weeks. It's even stranger that North Korean television told viewers that Kim is, quote, suffering physical discomfort. Normally, North Korean media simply does not discuss the health of the leader.
Well, because he's, you know, he's almost an immortal to many of the people there, and that's sort of the official viewpoint of the North Korean state, is that these people, he and his father and grandfather before that, are tantamount to gods.
Right. They are. So the fact that North Korean media is actually mentioning his health.
Right. State-run media. Yep.
You know, that says something right there. The article continues. It says, senior defectors have said that for some time, Kim Jong-un has been a public figurehead, while the real power has been exercised by the shadowy Organization and Guidance Department of the Korean Workers' Party. The visit to Incheon, too, was strange for several reasons. It is most unusual for North Korea to make an unannounced visit of any kind, let alone a visit south by such senior officials. Moreover, as a senior director pointed out, the visitors' behavior was odd. They smiled and chatted, which North Korean emissaries are not supposed to do.
Oh, wow.
The delegation leader appeared in a military uniform, which North Korea regards as a concession for special occasions. The delegation arrived with bodyguards, a privilege normally reserved in North Korea for the top leader, and did not gush the kind of praise of Kim Jong-un that would be expected. So what is going on? Nobody outside of Pyongyang knows for certain, and perhaps not too many people in Pyongyang know either. Mm. But we may be witnessing significant change in North Korea. It seems unlikely that Kim's absence really is due to poor health. If, as has been rumored, he had fractured his ankle, he could have still been filmed seated during the recent session of the Supreme People's Assembly that he missed. Huh. Even if he were so seriously ill as to be unable to appear at all for this amount of time, the regime could have disguised the fact, as it did with his father when he was sick. Because remember, there was that long period of time before Kim Jong-il died where he was sick, and people knew he was sick, but the state-run media was making up all of these excuses.
Now, presumably, this is speculation, and it's speculation based on them talking to, you know, North Korean defectors and experts and folks like
and
that.
And foreign top officials who have defected.
Yeah. So, I mean, it is still speculative, but I mean, I wonder what the speculation would be if they're not showing him. They're saying he's sick or he's injured,
right?
But they're not showing him in the hospital or whatever, because sometimes they'll do that stuff, like with Castro. You know, at one point they show him in the hospital.
Yes, yes.
Like, he's getting better. You know, that kind of thing, to sort of rally the country. Where would he be then? Like, you know, he's probably not in a work camp. Are they forcing him to stay out of the public view and he's just chilling somewhere? Where is this guy?
He's probably in one of his many presidential palaces or mm-hmm. whatever. And they're just like, all right, Kim, stay in here.
Yeah.
Don't come out.
Here's some video games, Tubby. You stay there.
Yeah. So the article says that it seems more likely that his absence is due to politics, not health. Huh. If Kim Jong-un has indeed been shunted aside, then whoever has replaced him has not moved into the limelight. Nobody has taken his place in visits to factories and military units. These visits appear simply to have stopped. Some have suggested that he's been effectively replaced by his younger sister, Kim Yo-jong, who, as a mere woman, would not be seen as a credible public figurehead right. in North Korea.
Oh, sorry, Ellen's here.
Oh, hi, everyone. How can you trust a woman with that kind of responsibility? I mean, really, what is she going to do with all that money? Spend it on shoes? That'll help North
Korea.
Does
North Korea have money?
Oh, there's money in
there's
the
money for the
palace.
Elite, I'm yeah. sure.
The article continues, it says, but the evidence for this seems very slight. On the other hand, senior defectors have said that for some time, Kim Jong-un has been a public figurehead. And huh. there's more.
All right, I definitely want to hear more about this because I find North Korea to be fascinating. We'll come back with that. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. 855-453. That's the toll-free number brought to you by ProXPN. This is Free Talk Live.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellawood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellawood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellawood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance, all with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever's on your mind. Just dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE, or join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. You can also find us online at freetalklive.com and get interactive there on the website. Joining you in studio tonight, Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
And you can get a free pound of some of the best coffee out there simply by going to coffee.freetalklive.com and get signed up for BuzzBox. BuzzBox is shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica. This is great coffee. And they're doing great work because we've teamed up with BuzzBox and Kiva to provide microloans to people all around the world looking to make a better life for themselves. The way we do this microloan thing is every 10 Free Talk Live listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com, that allows us to fund one new microloan to help make a better life for somebody, again, in a real tough part of the world. So coffee.freetalklive.com. All you have to do is pay the shipping cost to get your first pound free, and you can cancel your subscription at any time. So coffee.freetalklive.com.
Vice.com. Daryl, you have the story from Vice.com, which seems to be like the real go-to location for news about North Korea. They've done some amazing reporting out of North Korea on video. Of course, Vice really kind of, at least it came onto my radar when they first started putting these videos out. And in fact, I think it was their North Korean video was my first Vice video that I ever watched, and been a fan ever since of their work. The Vice documentaries from North Korea are well worth watching. There's three of them, I think, now at this point. And you should, if you're interested at all in North Korea, their perspective and what they do when they go there is absolutely fascinating. I highly recommend it. So you've got a story that's breaking. It was just posted hours ago.
Yes.
From Vice.com, suggesting that Kim Jong-un, who is the, was he the son?
He's the son of Kim Jong-il, isn't he?
Son of Kim Jong-il.
Right. Technically, his title is Marshal.
Okay.
Because Kim Il-sung...
Grandfather.
His grandfather was the supreme leader. His father was...
Dear leader?
They're all... whoever's in charge is dear leader.
Okay.
Beloved leader? Are there different levels of dear and beloved that we name them?
General, so they have military ranks.
Uh-huh.
So like, you know, the general and then whatever's below general and...
The Duke.
His, Kim Jong-un is called the Marshal. Like, that's his rank, is Marshal.
Doesn't sound as high up as general.
It's not. Right. It's a level below.
He was really, I mean, just from the get-go out there, he essentially was screwed, right? Because... he doesn't have the same reputation that his grandfather and father
or his
did.
Father, because he didn't grow up in Korea. Like, he was sent to private
school.
He went
to college in
somewhere
in Europe, I think.
Yeah,
right.
So, you know,
not only that, hasn't he been less of a devoted leader than the previous ones?
What do you mean by devoted?
I remember reading something a few years ago when he first gained power about how irresponsible he was being with it.
He did sort of come across as a young, bratty guy. I mean, he is, even his 30s yet? I think he's in his
20s. I don't think
so. So he's kind of, and he's also pudgy, you know, so he weighs a lot more than the average North Koreans who aren't
right,
eating.
Right, there's the meme that has been going around on the internet that says, it's tough being the fat kid in school. It's even tougher being the only fat kid in your country.
Yes, he appears to be very well fed. And well taken care of, and really wasn't in public light much at all before his dad started to sort of drift away in health. Then they sort of brought him out of nowhere, and so he hasn't had the same level of appearance and ability to really propagandize the people there. They haven't been raised. They've been raised to worship Kim Il-sung's statue and
right.
Kim Jong-il as well as these godlike people. And that whole god transition just didn't really play out for him.
Well, everybody already has the pictures of the previous leader. Like, they're not going to replace all of them.
Right. And so then you've also got...
Well, no, you don't replace the picture of one. Previous leader.
You just place it next to your old one?
You just add
to your collection.
Picture. Yes.
Eventually you have a gallery of leaders.
It's not like they have anything else up on their walls in their house. They have to have pictures of the dear leader up there. So, yeah, they got plenty of room for that. So, you know, he comes on board, and of course, he doesn't have any kids, from what I understand.
Right.
So there's no successor at this point.
Well, he's also not married.
Right. So there's no successor at this point, and the people who are in this, what was the OGD, was it?
The Organization and Guidance Department.
Yeah, so these people, the military guys there, are, you know, they're seeing this as their opportunity to seize some power for themselves.
Right. So
you think the military is going to stage a coup after he dies, and they're going to be leading, or
the coup's happened already?
Right.
Already.
That's the claim, is that the coup may have already happened. The article here continues. It says it is possible that the OGD has decided to remove Kim Jong-un as a figurehead.
But that would make it very unstable. Wouldn't there be somebody to rise to the top? And who's that going to be?
One of the OGD, I would imagine.
Right, it's pretty much, it seems as though it's sort of a military junta style of control.
Or they may rule by board. I mean, there may not be a single person that rises to the top.
Right, that's what I'm saying. It's sort of a military junta style thing. To where there's not one person, it's a collective. And Vice says that there are seemingly several reasons to remove Kim Jong-un as a figurehead. North Korea has struggled for more than a year to find a source of money to replace aid from China that was reduced following North Korea's third nuclear test in February of last year. Mm. The regime probably needs to, or rather needs that aid to secure the political loyalty of the Pyongyang elite. Although they now enjoy much better access to restaurants, coffee houses, and consumer goods than they did a few years ago, they have been steadily learning how poor they are compared to the Chinese,
yeah,
let alone compared to the South Koreans, and are demanding more goodies that the regime is struggling to provide. Mm. The regime has tried to secure significant investment from Russia, and senior North Korean officials have toured other countries in Europe trying to find money there, too. Both efforts have failed, and it is hard to see where the regime could now turn for financial assistance other than South Korea. Perhaps Kim resisted reaching out to the arch rival, and the OGD decided that for the regime as a whole to survive, Kim had to go. Some have said that if there was a coup, bloodless or otherwise, then we should observe movements of people and the military that do not seem to be occurring. A classic coup might provoke such movements, but a silent takeover by the OGD probably would not. The North Korean military is under the command of the Korean Workers' Party, and if the OGD decides to take Kim out of the limelight, it would be simple to instruct the party to order the military to carry on as usual. And with the OGD continuing to run the country, it would be business as usual for North Korean civilians.
Well, I think it's interesting, and I presume there's more to the story?
Not much. There's like another two paragraphs.
I think this is fascinating, and it'll be interesting to see how it plays out. They're already reaching out to South Korea, which is an unprecedented
yes.
thing. To have happen over there. And of course, it's not going to work out that they're just going to be able to get subsidies from other countries. If they really want prosperity, they're going to have to give people more freedom.
Yes.
Whether they're willing to do that or not remains to be seen. More coming up.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Next to water and food, you need a safe, storable fuel supply for your preparedness needs. Spare Fuel is the answer. Spare Fuel can be used in any gas-powered vehicle or generator. Spare Fuel is perfect for any unforeseen out-of-gas emergencies. Unlike gasoline, Spare Fuel is safe to store with your other supplies, and it can be stored for many years. Go to GetSpareFuel.com for special pricing. That's GetSpareFuel.com.
No different here.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, LionsOfLiberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at LionsOfLiberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you are invited here to take control of the airwaves. We got more coming up about North Korea. What is happening over there? Is Kim Jong-un still in charge? Or is he just a figurehead? Or is he even a figurehead now? He's been out of public view for 5 weeks. Is he even alive? Or is he being kept in some sort of room with a bunch of video games to keep him busy? Big little boy, essentially, an adult child. Running a country there. We'll find out more about that. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Our toll-free numbers are brought to you by ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. They encrypt your internet connection, meaning that your internet service provider, which right now is probably saving all of your surfing history, will no longer know what you're doing online once you start using ProXPN. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. And you can get started there for free. Download their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices. Linux users, setup's a little different for you, but it's pretty easy to get hooked up with Linux as well. ProXPN.com/FTL. So you can try it out for free, but when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, the ability to privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, sign up with code FTL50. And you'll save 50% off the price of their annual account for the lifetime of your account. So again, that's FTL50. And then there's also a different code for those of you who want to pay with Bitcoin. You'll get an even better discount on the annual plan with code FTLBTC. That's FTLBTC. And that'll save you 62% off of that annual account as well. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. So go to proxpn.com/FTL and don't forget to use promo code FTL50 or FTLBTC and get a great discount on privacy. That is priceless. I want to talk more about Kim Jong-un and North Korea in a moment here, but we actually have an international call from Cameroon, Africa. We've got Akko on the line with us. Akko, are you with us?
Yeah, hello, Freeman.
Hey, welcome. You're on with Ian and Ellen and Daryl, and you are calling us from Bamenda there in Cameroon. So
yes, I am calling you from the northwest region, of which the capital is called Bamenda.
Excellent. It's great to have you. You sound great, by the way. So welcome back to Free Talk Live. For our listeners who've been listening over the past few months, you may remember Akko called us to kind of talk about how he and a bunch of other folks are listening to Free Talk Live and LRN.FM out there in Cameroon, because the free-to-air satellite systems are very, very popular in that country. So what else is on your mind, Akko? Go ahead.
Yeah, Freeman. Right now, you have more than 200 listeners in Cameroon.
Fantastic.
They are receiving your signal through the satellite.
Thank you for that.
Unfortunately, internet here is unaffordable. People are hardly connected to the internet. Our government has made the internet too expensive, such that people should not be exposed to the outside world. That's why you have listeners who cannot interact with you.
How are you connected to the internet? Are you? I know you teach at a school there. How do you get online?
Yeah, right now I have spent about $10 to get this connection right now that I'm talking to you here. The connection here is too expensive and unaffordable. Not everyone can really afford it.
Now, when you say $10, is that $10 per month? How do they bill that?
No, here you buy your time in volume.
Uh-huh.
What I've bought now is 2 gigabytes, which is $10.
So once you run through the 2 gigabytes, then you got to pay for more bandwidth.
Yes, you got to pay again for more.
Okay, gotcha.
And the more data you download or you use, that's how it exhausts your time.
And who are you? Who's the company that's providing it? Is the government themselves, or is it a cell phone company? Who's doing that there?
It's a cell phone company. MTN, a South African company.
Do they have any competitors, or are they the only option?
They have only one competitor, which is Orange, another French company. But we also have a national company here, Camtel, Cameroon Telecommunications. But the government has done everything to make telecommunication in Cameroon impossible, because taking for instance that when the Arab Spring started, they were referring to it as Facebook Revolution. So our government here feels that if people are connected to the internet, people will be exposed to outside ideas,
right,
and they will get to criticize the government and even stand up against the government.
A reasonable concern from the government's perspective. So they've decided that they don't want their own Arab Spring happening in Cameroon, so make it very, very difficult to get people online.
So how is it that they're making it difficult? Are they?
It's expensive. It's just prohibitively expensive.
So they're just prohibiting any other company from springing up?
It's too expensive. Imagine in the U.S. buying 2 gigabytes of data for $10. I think if you compare our economic level here, you'll realize that we are
to the U.S. in the United States. That doesn't seem that doesn't seem crazy for the United States, but in Cameroon the GDP is much lower. I mean, the average person is
okay. Can you imagine in Cameroon more than 80%, 85% of the population lives below $1 per day.
Right. Yeah.
So we are dominantly a poor country. We have nothing to do when it comes to anything to do with wealth or a higher income level.
Yeah, $10. I mean, that's a lot of working if you're working in Cameroon.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah.
I've been packing this money for some time just to take part in this show. Do you remember the last time I took part on Free Talk Live? It was when I was in Chad, right in July.
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah, you were calling us from a location where you only had power because someone was able to run a generator to where you could
For me, I live in Ndop. Let me spell it, N-D-O-P.
Okay.
But I have to travel 40 kilometers from Ndop to come to Bamenda just to be connected to the internet.
40 kilometers. Now, was it 2.2 miles per kilometer or 2.2 kilometers per mile? I always forget.
10 kilometers is 2.2 like
kilometers
6 miles
per mile.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's quite a way. So you've traveled quite a ways and you've spent quite a bit of money just to come and talk to us tonight. I really appreciate that.
At 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. You know what I'd love to do is send you some. Do you have a Bitcoin wallet yet, Akko? Because I would love to send you some Bitcoin and help you pay for this.
we don't use Bitcoins yet.
Not yet.
Last time, one of my students asked me that he heard over the radio people were talking about Bitcoins. What is it? You know, I was stuck And I had to go and read about the Bitcoins to answer him that question. In order not to challenge myself as a teacher, I gave it as an assignment. It was when I got to know what Bitcoins was all about. But here in Cameroon, unfortunately, we don't use it.
Well, it would be hard, right? Because you need to have internet access in order to...
Or a cell phone. Because there's the company Coinapult, mm-hmm. and they're not paying us to say this, but there's the company Coinapult that they have the technology to where you can send Bitcoin through SMS.
And
through
I'm sure there's people in the chat room that want to send him money as well.
Through a non-smartphone.
Right.
The best thing to do is to send me some dollars, not bitcoins. Bitcoins, yeah, I will not be able to change it or to use it.
But it is hard. The thing with the dollars is it's hard to send those, right? So, like, there's MoneyGram and Western Union.
It is not hard. I can just forward my name to you so that you can send it through Western Union.
But Western Union, I don't know what they're going to charge me to send money to Cameroon, but it is not going to be cheap. You know, there was some news story recently about an African telecom company, a cell phone provider of some sort, and maybe it was MTN. Uh-huh. I don't remember. I'm going to have to look it up, see if I can find more information about that. But they had built in Bitcoin into a payment system there to where anybody with this cell phone company could use and send Bitcoin to one another.
You know, there are countries in Africa that are very advanced, like mm-hmm. South Africa, Nigeria, Ghana. But what we have here, the president that we have here is not different from the Kim Jong-un that you have been talking about in North Korea.
What's his name there in Cameroon, this scumbag?
We have a president here called Paul Biya. Paul Biya.
I love it. He types it out for me, too. Paul Biya, yes. B-I-Y-A. Can you hang on, Akko? Because yes. I'd love to continue the conversation. I know it's costing you, though.
Okay, no problem.
All right, hang on. We'll come back here in moments with more with Akko from Cameroon, Africa. And it's past midnight there right now, so he's up late for us. It's Free Talk Live. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty,
you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at shiresociety.com. That's shiresociety.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free. Bring up anything you want here at 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype us, as Akko is doing, from Cameroon, where he has traveled 40 kilometers just to find a place where he can get online. He has saved up enough money to purchase some gigabytes on the internet in order for him to talk to us here, which I really appreciate because I find it, you know, the perspective to be fascinating. It's does not sound like a lovely place to live at all. He says the corruption there is terrible, and the internet prices are ridiculous. The government there wants to keep internet out of the hands of the people because they don't want an Arab Spring happening in Cameroon. They don't want people getting ideas and rising up. But one thing the government can't do is they can't jam satellite signals. That's just not possible. There's a satellite up there called Amos 5, and it broadcasts Free Talk Live, and it broadcasts LRN.fm, and it broadcasts Daryl, your show, Peace, Love, Liberty Radio on Sundays. And they can listen to that with a very cheap receiver. All you have to do is have a cheap dish and a cheap receiver, and you can receive LRN.fm and Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for no monthly cost. And these things are cheap, cheap, cheap. The equipment costs nothing. So once it's installed, you're good to go. And he says he spread the word. He said he knows of at least 200 people who are active listeners.
Just in Cameroon.
Just in Cameroon of Free Talk Live.
And that's pretty impressive.
It's very exciting.
There's probably a bunch of people in Nigeria, which is one of the neighboring countries, the Central African Republic, which is on the other side, and I did a conversion. 40 kilometers is roughly 25 miles.
25 miles. So that's what he's gone through tonight. And what time is it there, Akko, in Cameroon?
It is exactly 48 minutes past 12 a.m.
So yeah, it's almost 1 a.m. there, and you're in Bamenda, which is the capital. You've borrowed a friend's laptop. Go ahead.
Mr. Ian, I have an announcement to make.
Please.
Yes, the Liberty Radio Network community here in Cameroon that I've gathered, the listeners, we are planning to come here as a group to come and have maybe a show with you in the near future. That's what we are planning to do.
Interesting. Okay. Well, that sounds like fun because I always enjoy talking to you, and I think that it's a fascinating perspective.
We are going to be about 20 of us who are willing to come here and have a show with you guys.
Interesting. Yeah, I definitely want to hear more about that when you put it together. So I'm sure you'll get in touch with me with details. But I know you were calling about something else tonight because we've kind of gone off into the world of what it's like living in Cameroon. Did you want to comment on the Ebola situation?
Yes, that Ebola situation is one of my concerns. Recently, whatever you find on the mainstream media, what you only hear about Africa is Ebola, Ebola, Ebola. You know, Africa is a continent made up of 52 countries.
Mm-hmm.
If just two countries or three countries are infected with Ebola, it doesn't mean that it is the whole continent that is infected. So the news that these so-called mainstream media are spreading across the globe are not true of Africa. We are a proud people with a diverse culture, the heritage. And when we hear things like that, we don't have to sit and fold our arms. We have to reject them. If they don't know much about Africa, they should come here. We are a proud people. It's just that we may be poor compared to other continents, but the stories that we keep hearing about Africa and Ebola, it is not true. Even in Liberia and Sierra Leone, I have friends who are living there, of whose they are living in areas where there are no infections, where nobody has been infected. So we are calling different media outlets to stop spreading these false rumors about Ebola and being an African issue.
Well, I appreciate that. And I hope you don't think we've been spreading those here on Free Talk Live, because I don't think we have at all. But that's what the media does, Akko, right? Like, and they, at least here in the United States, they sensationalize everything. They want people to be scared. In the U.S., there's a story today about somebody made a joke about Ebola on an airplane when the airplane arrived in, I think it was Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
They brought on some sort of hazmat team, and, you know, people are freaking out, even though, you know, next to no one has Ebola in anywhere in the United States.
How many Ebola jokes have I made in the past week, Ian? Time somebody sniffles, oh, it must be the Ebola.
It must be similar to saying, like, terrorist threat on an airplane or something.
I
saw a news headline the other day about Ebola hits 5,000 victims, and 5,000 doesn't seem, like, it seems pretty scary when you read it in a headline like that, but comparing it to the population of Africa alone, that's 1.033 billion people.
Just imagine we have about 52 to 53 countries in Africa. If just two countries are infected, it doesn't mean that the whole planet is infected.
Right.
I am living
right.
in Cameroon. We don't have it in Cameroon. Even though we have cases in Nigeria, the outbreak there has been, it was all over. So the mainstream media should stop circulating this news about Africa and Ebola.
Boy, I wish they would.
They should state the countries where there are these ongoing crises.
But they want people to be afraid. They want people to be afraid, so they'll keep tuning in for the latest updates. You know, I saw a neat chart that kind of put Ebola in perspective. They looked at Africa as just a continent in general, and then they listed all the different health problems that people have there. And of course, Ebola was down at the very, very bottom of the chart with, you know, next to no one suffering from Ebola, whereas AIDS, diarrhea, you know, there's all kinds
malaria.
Of real...
Malaria?
Yeah,
famine.
There's all kinds of real
Mr.
problems.
Ian.
Government?
Hello. Mr. Ian.
Yes, sir.
We are not poor in Africa. I quite remember that in the early 90s, Cameroon, our country, was giving financial aid to South Korea in the 90s.
Hmm. You mean North Korea?
South Korea.
I can't imagine South Korea would have needed it in the 90s. They're fairly wealthy over there.
Yes. Cameroon was giving aid, more than $2 million, getting to $3 million to South Korea for humanitarian aid. Okay, compare our country now to South Korea. You will understand that we are not poor. What is killing us is our government.
Mm-hmm.
A group of individuals who have just made themselves to decide the destiny of millions of people. It doesn't mean that we are poor. In Cameroon here, we have all resources that you can ever think of. We have petrol, we have bauxite, we have rubber, we have banana, we have plantain, we have coffee, all of those things that we are exporting. But at the end of the day, the money ends
in the government's pocket.
This is where the ministers are going to embezzle it. So if we are poor in Africa, the international community should not think that we are inherently poor.
Mm.
But they should look at our government and accuse them of the corruption that is killing, and it is derailing the progress of millions of people.
So these government gangsters there in Cameroon, this Paul Biya, how did he take power? What's the story there? Do they claim to even have elections? How does that work there?
Okay, imagine a president who conduct an election and win 76% of the vote. Just imagine.
Wow.
The whole process is going to be rigged. Okay, he took power from Ahmadu Ahidjo, our first president. Who was ill and he was incapacitated. He cannot exercise his duty. So he passed power over to Paul Biya in 1982.
Wow, he's been there that long?
in 1982 when I was not born.
Yeah, I was born in 1980, so that's a long time to hold power. Incredible.
I was born in 1985, so I was born when he was in power. I've grown old. I've done things. Very soon, maybe I will get married and start begging children while he's there in power. And you know what? He's an old man. He's somebody above 80.
81 years old.
He cannot do anything. More than 82.
Yeah.
Getting to 82 years. He can't do anything. He knows nothing about the good of the greatest majority of our country. He's just there turning one minister from one ministry to the other. And things are getting bad.
Akko, I really appreciate you calling in tonight. Was there anything else you wanted to throw out on the airwaves this evening?
I just want to say I miss you guys. We always want to take part in your show, but it is due to our internet connectivity here that is not always available. We have to travel 40 kilometers to get into contact with you guys.
I appreciate the call, and I appreciate your time and effort tonight, Akko. And we'll see what we can figure out with this whole Bitcoin thing, because I'd much rather send Bitcoin over to you than send MoneyGram. So we got to figure something out there. But thank you for the call tonight, and thanks for traveling all that way.
Thank you very much.
What
about the female voice? Is it Angel Clark?
No, this is Ellen. She's here only on Friday nights.
Ah, okay. I thought it was the Angel Clark. We always listen to the Angel Clark show.
Angel, unfortunately, has had to cut her show back to one show per week. She's now on Wednesdays, and she's on a little bit earlier than before over on LRN.FM.
Last time I was listening to Freedom Fiends.
Yeah, but now you get more Freedom Fiends as a result of that. So, hey, thanks for the call, Akko. Have a good night out there, and get some sleep when you get a chance. More coming up here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Little Jack Horner sat in a corner of his ransacked apartment, wondering what kind of nitwit steals a futon. Luckily, the Geico Insurance Agency had helped him with renter's insurance, and he got full replacement. Unfortunately, little Jack Horner had to have his stomach pumped when he ate a six-month-old Christmas pie. Visit geico.com to see how affordable renter's insurance can be.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,229, silver around $17.56, and Bitcoin around $370. Today's precious metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Well, Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free script ASIC miner. Visit sovereignminers.com to buy your miner today. In the news, on Wednesday, arguments concluded in a hearing on force-feeding at the Guantanamo Bay Military Prison. Lawyers with Human Rights Group Reprieve represented Syrian detainee Abu Wail Diab in a hearing that will determine the legality of the force-feeding and whether or not 32 videos of the procedure will be released to the public. Diab's team presented three expert witnesses while the government failed to present any. Judge Gladys Kessler is expected to rule on the matter in the coming weeks. Thousands of demonstrators marched through Mexico's capital this week, calling on the government to investigate missing students and a recently discovered mass grave. 43 students went missing after a clash with police in Iguala in the state of Guerrero on September 26. A mass grave filled with burned human bodies was also found over the weekend. Guerrero's attorney general said it was probable that some of the 28 bodies found belonged to the missing students. On Monday, New York Supreme Court Justice Paul Wooten ruled that the high-rise safety initiative will not appear on the November 4th ballot. The initiative was an effort to investigate all high-rise collapses on or since September 11, 2001, including World Trade Center 7. Justice Wooten sided with a court-appointed referee's recommendations that the petition to be on the ballot be denied. However, the justice called the city's efforts to dismiss the case based on technicalities irrational and misplaced, and would lead to disenfranchisement of more than 30,000 registered voters without due process. Support for Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, 100% natural teeth whitener. Polishes teeth and detoxifies the mouth. Visit MyMagicMud.com to buy your jar of My Magic Mud today. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Well, you can. Simply log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com, Amazon. That's right. You can help the Liberty Beat continue to deliver hard-hitting Liberty news and activist updates by doing your Amazon shopping after following our link at thelibertybeat.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. To celebrate both the Liberty Beat's new partnership with the Genesis Communications Network and alternative media in general, the Liberty Beat proudly invites you to Be the Media. This all-day event will happen Saturday, October 25th, at Brave New Books in Austin, Texas, hosted by the Liberty Beat in partnership with the Austin Agorist Alliance and Brave New Books. The event will be live-streamed so non-Austinites can also take part. The day will feature an intensive do-it-yourself journalism workshop, lectures, panel discussions, networking, a soapbox idol rant-off, and a launch party to celebrate the new partnership between the Liberty Beat and GCN. Confirmed speakers include Adam Kokesh of the Freedom Line, Michael Cargill of Come and Talk It, Heather Fazio of Texans for Accountable Government, Harlan Dietrich of The Crypto Show, Matthew Medina of Truth Exposed Radio, Joel Williamson of the Alliance of Austin Agorists, and the Liberty Beat's own Derek Brose, John Bush, and Catherine Bleich. If you're looking for a more intimate and intensive learning experience, you can join John Bush before the bookstore is even open to the public for a do-it-yourself journalism intensive crash course. This portion of the event has limited seating, and tickets will go on sale soon. Sign up to compete in the Soapbox Idol competition or pre-register for the morning workshop at thelibertybeat.com. Support our expansion while you learn how to be the media. See you at Brave New Books, Saturday, October 25th. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from The Corey Moore Show. With a focus on all things topical and liberty-oriented, Corey Moore and his band of co-hosts keep a sense of humor while attacking the state. It's The Corey Moore Show, live each Friday night, 9 o'clock Central, 10 o'clock Eastern, at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is The Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
From that romantic summer evening in 1924 when Pol Pot was conceived, to the first time someone figured out how to eat a pineapple without ripping their mouth to shreds, this week in history. 1692, five citizens were executed after being convicted during the Salem witch trials.
all while dozens of witches, warlocks, and sorcerers stood by and watched the wrongly accused take the rap for them, while a perfectly normal humans charged with witchcraft were publicly hung and dragged to their unmarked graves, the numerous Salem citizens that did spend their evenings casting spells and awakening the dead merely lowered their heads as their friends and neighbors were burned at the stake.
Historical records have indicated that as many as 35% of the people in Salem were actually witches and warlocks. In fact, the executioner himself was a well-known necromancer who, after hanging the wrongly accused witches, reanimated their dead bodies and apologized before casting them into the eternal fires of hell.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want, toll free. Talking about, or we're going to continue discussing, the Kim Jong-un situation in North Korea, just because I find it fascinating what's happening out there. North Korea, of course, is just, it's like a train wreck of a country to, you know, it's so horrifying, but yet you can't look away from it. So I want to learn more about what's going on there, because the suggestion is that Kim Jong-un is no longer in control of the country, and in fact that he may not have been in control for the majority of 2014.
And part of 2013, according to an article that I read earlier in the week.
Right. And so we get a little bit more from Vice News at vice.com on that story. Also, we had Akko call in from Cameroon, Africa, in the last hour. And he actually had to spend quite a bit of money and time and effort to come to the capital where he could get access to the internet by borrowing a friend's laptop and a cell phone card. They had apparently had to rent a hotel room as well, and finally was able to connect to us to kind of talk to us about various different things, which is fascinating stuff.
Can you imagine the level of dedication that it takes? You know, like, this guy spent a bunch of time and money so that he could call his favorite radio station.
He must have a lot of love for you.
Yeah, I mean, no one will do that.
And like
in the United States, at least.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Here in the U.S., it's difficult to get people to, you know, like walk a mile down the street or even drive a mile down the street to go to an anti-war vigil or to, you know, like go to some political rally so that you can heckle the politician or to, you know, drive an hour to go to Concord to testify to legislators.
Speaking of which, there's a court case on Wednesday, isn't there?
There's a couple of them, actually.
In Concord?
There's one in Concord. The Robin Hood case is going to the Supreme Court. For our listeners who are new to the show, Robin Hooding is making international headlines this week. The UK's Telegraph doing a story. From what I understand, the BBC has yet to release their story, but they interviewed James Cleveland, who is also known as Robin Hood here in Keene. Robin Hooders are known internationally for saving people from getting parking tickets in downtown Keene, New Hampshire, which is where we do this show from. The case that's going to the Supreme Court essentially has the city of Keene suing the Robin Hooders, and I'm one of them, and they're alleging in their suit that we are harassing, threatening, and intimidating their employees.
And preventing them from doing their job. And I allege that based on their interpretation of preventing the parking enforcers from doing their job, based on testimony by the parking enforcers that their job is to write parking tickets, that anyone putting money in any meter
is preventing them from doing their job.
So arrest me the next time I park downtown for preventing them from doing their job, for putting a nickel in my meter.
They can't arrest you. They would love to arrest the Robin Hooders, but they obviously can't. Otherwise, they would have.
They're
by
not
now.
Actual police enforcers. Officers or law
They've
enforcers,
called the police. So the parking department bureaucrats work
parking
for the
services.
Police. Yeah, that's right. They call themselves parking services now instead of parking enforcement. But they work for the police department. It's a division of the police. But they themselves, I don't think, have arrest powers. They have to call in the police to arrest you. And they've called the police a number of times on the Robin Hooders.
But
they
don't have the cuffs. They don't even have mace, do they?
No.
I don't know if they have. I don't know if they carry any kind of weapon, but.
A radio.
The police themselves, when they are called into the scene, have never made an arrest of a Robin Hooder. So because there's nothing for which to arrest them. In fact, the job description also says they're supposed to endure verbal and mental abuse. Right. And that's not what I think Robin Hooders are doing to them. But even if they were doing that, it should be also be fully
right.
illegal.
And that's what the judge at the Superior Court said, is it doesn't really matter if there is harassment going on because it's protected speech.
Right. So that's going on Wednesday. And
one thing, I plan on being there.
Excellent.
And live tweeting. But people don't necessarily have to rely on my tweets to know what's going on, because the Supreme Court live streams their stuff.
Amazing. I wish they would do that in all the courtrooms across New Hampshire.
So it's only the audio.
That's happening on Wednesday. Also on Wednesday, unless it gets postponed, will be my sentencing, where I'm facing up to 2 years in jail for filling out a DMV form 2 days later than it was legally able to be filled out in the way that I filled it out.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah.
So that's exactly
maybe the last time you see me for
charge?
A while.
When is that happening?
Also Wednesday morning, unless I get it postponed. I've attempted to get a continuance on the sentencing in that case.
Well, I wish you well in that.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I find it kind of ridiculous that a paperwork issue could lead to 2 years in jail.
Hopefully it won't. I'm fascinated to see what the sentence is, because I want to see. I would love, if I end up going to jail, I hope somebody does the research on the outside to actually pull up some cases of actual fraud where somebody got, oh, there's that lady here in Keene. There's a woman who works for, who's one of the Stop Free Keene members, who has been indicted on at least one felony count, maybe more than one, I'm not sure, of embezzlement. She was working for another member of Stop Free Keene, and these are some of the folks who don't like the liberty activists.
Is this really a surprise?
The embezzling?
Yeah.
It was a surprise to the woman who was her employer, I can tell you that. She was essentially her chief assistant. She was her kind of her right-hand girl and did all the, you know, the office work for this lady who was her employer. And she's alleged to have embezzled, I don't know, $200,000 or something like that. So she's facing some pretty serious charges. And I just find myself wondering what is her sentence going to be in a case like that, as opposed to me, who I filled out a DMV form, 48 hours too late, basically.
Right, but the two aren't necessarily comparing apples and apples here.
Right, one's real fraud, the other's alleged
fraud. So, well, yeah, and the charges are totally different.
Oh, I know that. I'm just talking about, like, the idea behind what happened in my case is it's an ID issue, right? I had my name changed legally,
right.
And then 2 days after that, I went into the DMV and I got a driver's license in my original name, simply through expediency,
right.
With the intention of changing it later on the driver's license, and ultimately
right.
did change it later on. So, all that's been taken care of. I didn't use that other name for any sort of fraudulent purpose to defraud anybody or, scam somebody out of money.
Right.
Yeah,
but that's not what the statute says. The statute didn't allege that you used the name for fraudulent purposes, just alleged that you used a name that wasn't yours.
Well,
and according
it was
to
my name originally. It was given
right,
to me by my parents.
But according to the state, as soon as you got the piece of paper saying that your name is no longer Ian Bernard,
yeah.
as far as they're concerned, you are no longer Ian Bernard.
No, I understand
if you
that.
Use the name
but
Ian
even
Bernard.
Even though you function as the same person under
yes.
both names?
But isn't the intention of that legislation to
the intention
to
might
stop
be,
fraud?
That might be the intention,
yeah.
but that's not what's written into the statute.
I understand that. They're not alleging I defrauded anyone. They're saying that I didn't follow their rules completely,
right.
whatever the hell those are. But my point is, will someone who actually did commit fraud against another person be subject to a more stringent punishment as me, who simply violated a rule of the state, or will I be subject to a more stringent punishment than someone who actually defrauded somebody out of $200,000?
I would speculate that you will get the worst punishment because
you
committed the ultimate offense.
Right.
You disobeyed the state.
Yes, I suspect you're right about that as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, whereas the person who actually committed fraud and stole the $200,000, they might just be fined and maybe sent to jail for a few months or something, but I don't foresee them going for, not nearly as long as 2 years.
I would speculate probation and restitution.
She's also facing a felony as well. So mine are two misdemeanor, Class A misdemeanor charges, which is where the maximum 2 years comes in. She's probably looking at a maximum of 3 to 7, but it's probably her first conviction. And so, what will that end up being?
Probation and restitution.
Yeah. So we shall see next week on that one. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. You can take control of the airwaves. We've still got other things to discuss here tonight, including it looks like Amazon is thinking about opening up their first ever brick-and-mortar store in a very strange move. But we still have more to talk about with North Korea coming up here in moments. Kim Jong-un, is he alive? Is he being kept somewhere? Is he actually sick, as they claim that he's suffering some sort of health effects? Is he still
broken
in charge?
Broken ankle and gout?
Is he still in charge of the country? Some people say he is not, and that there's a group of people called the OGD, that is the Organization and Guidance Department. And is their being in charge going to result in more freedom or some semblance of it for the North Korean people? More on the way. It's Free Talk Live. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, October 8th, 2014, gold opened at $12,1880. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $12,6360, $631.80 for a half ounce, or $315.90 for a quarter ounce. That's $12,6360, $631.80, and $315.90.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
you're on account.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running?
Because you're scared of me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free. Bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy our features we share with you. Those other talk shows, they want to charge you for accessing their websites. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. Now, if you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support the show, then you can throw something into the Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. And if you don't yet have any Bitcoin, then maybe you want to consider going and getting some over at expresscoin.com. Now, you need to have a wallet first. So go and get your free Bitcoin wallet at blockchain.com. And then you can, once you have your Bitcoin wallet set up, go to expresscoin.com to load it up with Bitcoin or a fraction of a Bitcoin. You don't have to buy an entire Bitcoin. One Bitcoin, something like $370 or something close to that amount, $350, $370 today. So you can buy a fraction of that. You can buy $40 worth of Bitcoin through expresscoin.com. And if you buy less than $40 worth and you use code FTL, you'll get it for no transfer fee. So you pay nothing on top of the actual cost of the Bitcoin that you buy. So go to expresscoin.com, use code FTL to get less than $40 worth for zero fee. Once again, that's expresscoin.com. They take money order, check, wire transfer, or even cash deposit at local credit unions that have shared branching, as it's called, or shared banking? Shared branching.
Shared branch.
Shared branching. This copy is incorrect. Anyway, they're also a licensed money service business, and you can do it all from your smartphone via their app or your favorite computer. So go to expresscoin.com, and don't forget coupon code FTL. Daryl, you were sharing with us some Vice News coverage of Kim Jong-un. The question is he still in charge of North Korea? Vice says, from the people they've talked to, you know, former North Koreans and people who know a thing or two about what goes on over there, it's hard to know what's actually going on
right
in North Korea. So a lot of it's speculative, but we do know that Kim Jong-un has not been seen publicly for several weeks.
Yes,
which
5 weeks.
Very unusual.
Right. Something must be up. And it may just be a coincidence, but I think that's kind of a small probability, seeing as, you know, he's the supreme leader and he's supposedly the one that makes all the decisions. So if he's not around when there's big important meetings going on, then how is he able to make decisions that are informed?
Not only is he making decisions for the country's government, but he also has designed gyms, for instance. I mean, this guy really,
and trained the dolphins at Korean SeaWorld.
He does everything. Everything that is good in North Korea is thanks to Kim Jong-un.
And runs the reformation camps, or concentration camps, or whatever you
want
to call
those.
They
are reform through labor camps.
Oh, that's right.
Sounds like community service.
Didn't they recently admit that they existed?
Someone from North Korea went to the European Union and stopped at some UN headquarters in Europe. And during an interview, he did briefly mention them, but he quickly corrected himself after calling them camps and called them something else. I had reported on that story earlier in the week on one of the FPP radio news.
They're not camps. They're clubs, like Club Med.
Fun clubs.
Yeah. And you can be born and bred into them.
It's true.
Right. Three generations.
You can even be sent to them if one of your family members commits a crime.
Yes.
Because it's in your blood. You're just part of that club forever.
You're just bad.
Right. And one of the articles that I had reported on earlier, I had actually read the article on Peace, Love, Liberty Radio, which is the show that I do on Sundays, suggested, and this article doesn't mention, but remember when Kim Jong-un's uncle was executed? That was, and of course this is speculation, that was sort of a public showing that the Kim family is no longer in charge.
Mm.
Because if the Kim family was in charge, they would never allow one of their relatives to be executed.
And it just seems even more eerie looking at it from a Western perspective, because we have no idea what's going on in the country. We have very little information coming out of there. So really, a lot of this is just speculation.
Right. And the article that I've been reading tonight from Vice says, if the speculation is correct, that being that the Kim family is no longer in charge and that it's the OGD, then it's not surprising that the delegation that traveled to Incheon earlier in the week...
That's South Korea.
South Korea behaved atypically, for grizzled senior cadres used to a lifetime of kowtowing to the Kims, their first visit abroad without having to answer to the dynasty would have felt like liberation. Mm. They even got to fly in Kim's personal plane.
Oh, wow.
The visitors to Incheon did not bring a letter from Kim, which some have seen as a sign that North Korea is not serious about improving relations with the South. But perhaps there is another explanation.
And that perhaps, is that he's not in charge.
Perhaps Kim Jong-un is simply not writing letters anymore, which would mean that he's not in charge.
Right. I think that's fascinating. Now, can you imagine what it would be like to, I don't know, I mean, these are the senior officials, so there's a good chance they've left North Korea in the past, but just to be from North Korea and to travel to South Korea to experience the tremendous difference in culture and wealth. I mean, South Korea is so wealthy by comparison.
And this is, based on what this said, this is their first time traveling without Kim, which means that, you know, it's a whole new level.
They could totally cut loose and go to the clubs.
That's why it says it must have felt like liberation. Right.
Yeah, they're going to start doing all kinds of illegal things now. Maybe never go back.
They'll start acting like the Secret Service and hiring prostitutes and starting crank off of them.
Well, probably anything they do in South Korea would be illegal in North Korea if you did the same thing.
Well, imagine just going anywhere else if you're in North Korea. Like, that could just be a gateway to a whole new life.
Yeah, so there's some fascinating stuff in here. I've actually got a story from also from Vice News from earlier this week, where they talk about Jang Sung-taek. That was the uncle that was executed.
Yes.
Basically, they said that totally broke everything. You can't just touch a Kim family member publicly. It's the OGD's claim to legitimacy. It's them saying no one is more legitimate than them. By Jang dying, Kim Jong-un is now surrounded by the OGD. The New Focus International, this is a different Jang who runs this. That's... somebody who's escaped, reported on the coup in December and dissected the politics that were at play. According to New Focus International's report, the OGD has exercised virtual control over North Korea since its foundation by Kim Jong-il in the early 1990s. Other members of the government and the military became honorary power holders and proxies, while the men who exercised power on behalf of Kim Jong-il remained behind the scenes. Through the parallel OGD structure then as now, it described Kim Jong-un as the avatar of the Kim family cult and the legitimizing face of a state ruled by the OGD. Remco Brucker, a professor of Korean studies at Leiden University in the Netherlands, which hosted a conference of elite North Korean exiles in September, says Jang isn't the only former senior regime official to suggest that the OGD is a shadow government that rules behind the scenes with Kim Jong-un as a figurehead. Quote, "The real power resides with that one department, the OGD, that was groomed to bureaucratic perfection by Kim Jong-il. When he was alive, he was in practical sense heading the department. Kim Jong-un is not. It serves him, but it more serves the legacy of Kim Jong-il, and those don't always coincide." We'll continue with more. You're welcome to share your thoughts as well here at 855-450-FREAK. Coming up, how to get out of a parking ticket.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988.
Herbal Healer Academy.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips, tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free, bring up whatever's on your mind. Our very own Derek J. Freeman beat a parking ticket the other day, which is great news, right? Right after we were talking on the air about not taking a plea deal and what can happen when you do that, he made it real for us. We'll tell you a little bit more about that. Plus, we're sharing more on the story out of North Korea. Vice News has more detail from a different story. Daryl, you had given us some info about speculation about what was going on possibly with Kim Jong-un, who has disappeared from public view for several weeks. There are obviously a lot of rumors, a lot of speculation as to what's actually going on there. Ian, Ellen, and Daryl in the studio here, you can join us by phone at 855-450-FREE or worldwide via Skype at username lrn.fm. The story I have here is from a few days ago, and they talked to a gentleman here, Jen Jing-sung, who's a former key member of Kim Jong-il's propaganda machine. What happened was an elite group of exiles from North Korea gathered in September in the Netherlands to discuss the state of the regime they used to serve. The conference included top diplomats, an ex-senior official of the Ministry of Security, and a high-ranking military officer. The keynote address was given by Jang Jin-sung, the key member of their propaganda machine there. Included in his speech was a surprising assertion, and that is that North Korea is in the midst of a civil war. Now, according to Jang, who's a former counterintelligence official and poet laureate under Kim Jong-il, members of the government's organization and guidance department, the OGD, which Daryl was telling us about, has stopped taking orders from Kim Jong-un. He says they have taken effective control of the country, and a conflict is simmering between factions that want to maintain absolute control over the economy and others seeking to gain wealth through foreign trade and a slightly more open market. I mean, these guys can't be unaware, as senior officials, people who, in theory, have some level of understanding of the world around them, they can't be unaware that South Korea hasn't just magically been successful, that there's a reason why South Korea is dramatically more wealthy than
right.
North Korea.
But it seems like for such a restricted country as North Korea, if they were to make the market even slightly more free, it would be only because they understand that their country is not making as much money as it could.
That's right.
And
therefore,
once
they're not as wealthy as
yeah,
they could be.
Yeah, once they start making more money, they could be even richer than they are now.
Well, that's true. But if that's the motivation that gets North Koreans the ability to, I don't know, own some of the stuff that they make or own the property that they live on or have some level.
But I'm just wondering if the citizens are even going to benefit from something like that, or if all of the excess profit is just going to be swept up by, you know, people who are holding powerful positions.
That's a good question. And a lot of it has to do with, you know, who runs the businesses, who actually owns the businesses. And, you know, based on my limited knowledge of North Korea, I'm fairly certain that everything is owned by the government in North Korea, which would mean that, you know, a few elites would wind up, you know, getting the profits.
Well, now look, if you look at Cuba as an example, and I can't say I'm an expert here, but we've seen a few stories from Cuba since Raul Castro took over after, you know, Fidel, he passed away. When Raul Castro took over, there were some reforms that were implemented that, from what I understood of these reforms, allowed farmers, for instance, to actually decide what to grow on the, you know, on portions of their own property.
On portions of their property.
Yeah.
Wow, that's so generous.
Well, you know, when you have no control whatsoever and there's now, you know, 10% of control given to you.
Okay, you have to plant corn on all of this property except this tiny corner. You can whatever you want.
Or they could keep some of the, you know, the stuff that they reaped rather than having to turn it all over to the state. It little things like that, when you have absolutely nothing, can make a difference. I mean, for us, it seems like nothing, but
right.
for them, it could mean the world. It could
one
mean the
small
difference
step
between
at a time.
Starving or not starving.
Well, one other thing that would really help the Cuban people is if the U.S. government would lift this damn embargo.
Oh, yeah. Which has been there for decades.
Been there for decades. Allow Americans to travel to Cuba. Can you imagine how many millions, possibly billions of dollars the Cuban people are missing out on?
In tourism,
you know,
money?
What's
sure.
funny
because
is
I can't travel there. You can't travel there. 310 million Americans can't travel there for vacation.
And it's ironic that we've been talking about North Korea tonight because the embargo on North Korea has been lifted for several years now. The embargo on Cuba,
really?
Still there.
Really?
It's not even like, oh, we just signed it in and it's just there. They renew it every year.
How the hell do you get a ticket to Pyongyang anyway?
I don't know.
You have to get special permissions from the North Korean
right.
government first.
Okay, but that's interesting. So you're saying you can actually fly from the United States to Pyongyang?
I'm just saying there's no embargo
in
on North
theory.
Korea anymore.
In theory.
Yes. I mean, I doubt that the country, North Korea, would let you in very easily. Like, you might have to have some special, like, get so many people to sign this form and have certain credentials. But,
oh, yeah, and they'll be waiting for you when you arrive, take you on the official track, because you can't
yes.
leave the official tour
right.
of North Korea.
They've got the cardboard castles set up in the background.
Unless you're Vice.
And all the good actors
basically
staging
snuck
scenes.
In. Yeah, it's so creepy. Have you seen those documentaries?
I have not seen documentaries. I've read documentations,
mm-hmm.
but no, I haven't seen any documentaries.
Watch the Vice, if you have time. Watch the, and there's they're in segments.
And their documentaries are fairly,
fairly
short.
Yeah, usually like an hour or less. But watch the Vice documentaries in order from North Korea, because there's sort of a story that's told of that arcs to some extent over them. But there's one of them where they actually sort of sneak into the country via a Siberian train. And it's pretty amusing, actually, when they're on the train, because they're on with this boisterous kind of drunk Russian guy who's total, this total stereotype. this Russian soldier.
Potato vodka in one hand.
He's had a lot of vodka. I don't know what kind of vodka it was, but
all vodka comes from potatoes.
Is that right?
Okay. Yes.
Now I've learned something. I didn't know. I learned something new every night here on Free Talk Live.
That's like saying, like, you know, cactus tequila. All tequila comes from a cactus.
Really?
Well, it's kind of good to explain, just in case somebody in the room doesn't understand.
Thank you for that.
Grape wine.
Comes from grapes?
All wine comes
from... Is it white or purple? You don't... Is it red? Red wine? White
doesn't
wine?
Matter. It still comes from grapes.
But different types of grapes.
Good yes, point.
But still so, grapes.
Jang, here's the... this is the guy who is the former... propaganda minister over in North Korea. He has escaped and gave a keynote address at the conference of former exiles, or exiles rather, not former, but exiles from North Korea in the Netherlands. He said that on one hand, it's people who want to maintain a regime monopoly, and on the other hand, it's not like people are fighting against the regime, but in a policy sense, they want to take advantage to get influence. It's not actually consciously a civil war, but there are these two incompatible forces at play. Jang's statements come during a moment of peak curiosity about the Hermit Kingdom. King Kim Jong-un, the portly 31-year-old who assumed the title. He's 31, okay, so he's just out of his 20s.
And they call him portly. How nice.
He is a tubby one. He assumed the title of Supreme Leader after his father's death in 2011, has been absent from public view for over a month. He was last seen walking with a pronounced limp during a July ceremony commemorating the death of his grandfather, Kim Il-sung. He typically presides over the Supreme People's Assembly, a rubber-stamp parliament, but missed the meeting in early September and was replaced by a propaganda video that again showed him limping. Despite some discomfort, our marshal continues to come out and lead the people, said the film's narrator. Which, that sounds right for, you know, one of these sort of dictatorship countries where they have this supreme grand leader. If the person is injured, they want to show how strong they are. They want to show, you know, video that they're on the recovery. They're on the mend, right, just like the country. You
or
know?
They never got sick in the first place. They just powered through it.
That's what the media did with FDR. They never showed FDR in his wheelchair.
Really?
They never showed FDR struggling to stand up from the wheelchair.
Every broadcast of him, he was behind his desk.
He was either behind the desk or already standing behind the podium, and then the camera started rolling.
We will return with more from the Hermit Kingdom, as it's called, North Korea. Fascinating stuff.
They have unicorns.
You can share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And join us as well on Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. And more on the way, plus parking tickets. Our buddy Derek J got out of one this week. It's Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
Question: could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer: yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro-EM1 from Terriganics. Pro-EM1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled Terraganix.com, or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro EM1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
Free Talk Live.
They believe, I think, that government can be good as long as you just elect the right people, which, of course, is nonsense. Government can never be good because it's an agency of coercive force. It doesn't matter who's running it. It doesn't matter what the goals of the organization are. As long as it's funded through coercion, as long as it's funded through threats of violence, then nothing it can do is ever moral or justified. They understand the system and they want to work inside it to change it. So, therefore, in order to have their hunger strike that they'd planned, which I thought was a great idea, they went to the government, and what'd they do?
Ask for a permit?
They asked for a permit. They asked for a permit. It was already over at that point, right? Whenever you ask permission from the government, you might as well expect them to say,
no.
No!
You know what? It sounds like government has this non-cooperation thing down to a science.
Yeah, right?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live, and welcome your calls at 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio, it's Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
Don't forget to check out Daryl on his website, fpp.cc. There are all kinds of things available through fpp.cc. There's articles that you write, Daryl, the weekly, or not weekly, but the weekly shows that you do. You do Peace, Love, Liberty Radio. You do a newscast every single day of the week.
250 consecutive days today.
Congratulations. You are will be at a whole year before you know it.
Yes.
And so there's that audio segment of fpp.cc. There's the bloggy kind of segment. And then there's also, you make your own newspaper as well.
I do.
And you're a book publisher.
Yes.
I don't know how you find time for it all. Plus, you do affiliate relations work for Free Talk Live, so folks can go and check more of you out over at fpp.cc. As we go to your phone calls and thoughts, we'll do that here in a moment, but also want to tell you about how to collect some Bitcoin bounties. There is a Bitcoin bounty available right now for 38 Bitcoins, and there's some others also available over at BitcoinBountyHunter.com. You can use your investigative skills and collect the bounty. The authorities aren't going to be solving these cases. It'll be done by people like you who can profit and gain from your work and your skill. You can also create bounties on BitcoinBountyHunter.com, or you can even add to the ones that already exist. So if you want to help incentivize the solving of a particular case, you can add to that. Go check it out at BitcoinBountyHunter.com. As we go to Zach in Chicago, we'll talk more about Kim Jong-un and what's happening in, or what's alleged to be happening in North Korea. Nobody really knows for sure. Zach, you're on Free Talk Live in Chicago.
Hey, yeah, what's up?
Hey, Zach, you're on the air. Go ahead.
All right, so I have some questions about the Free State Project.
Sure, go for it.
So I am thinking about going to Keene State, actually. I'm looking into some colleges in the New Hampshire area because, I mean, I've been listening to you guys for a while, and I'd love to be a part of that. And I was wondering if there are there a lot of, like, college kids involved with the Free State Project, or is it more of an older demographic?
Ellen is the youngest of the three hosts in the studio tonight. What do you think about that, Ellen?
I would say don't come here expecting to find college students that agree with you.
There's really no college students that are involved in Free Keene or the Free State Project, as far as I know. Maybe if you went to Porkfest, you'd meet some, but I haven't met any around Keene.
In the Manchester area, and not to cut you off.
Oh, yes, in Manchester, there's a few.
There's the Students for Liberty at UNH Manchester. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure how active it is, know that it exists.
Or how many of them are Free Staters and in Students for Liberty.
Right, but even if they're pre-staters or natives or just came here and then decided that they like liberty, there's at least a chapter, so there's some kind of liberty organization for students.
I know that on the Keene State campus, there is a Keene Cannabis Coalition group that is fairly new. That seems to be well populated.
Did that replace the SSDP?
It may have. There was also formerly the Students for Sensible Drug Policy. I don't know if that group still exists. The thing with college students, and so I take it you haven't yet started college at any point?
I'm going to a community college right now in Illinois.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're planning on wrapping up 2 years at a community college and then going to another 2 years at a regular college?
Well, I actually did something interesting. I hated government schools my entire life, so I took some action and got out. I did some homeschooling starting my junior year, and I finished high school in a year. I finished 2 years of high school in a year. And,
wow. Congrats.
And then I started attending my, thank you. I started attending my local community college because I hated it. You know, I was one of those kids that I would never stand up for the pledge. I did all that stuff that everyone in the government schools hated, and I was just, it was awful.
Well, it sounds like you'll fit right in with the Free Staters up here, whether you're in Manchester or Keene or wherever it is that that you end up.
What are you studying?
Political science, actually. Political science. I'm trying to minor in history.
That's interesting.
So, yeah, what do you do with a political science degree, though, besides teach?
Become Karl Rove.
That's my problem. I'm definitely, I don't know if I'd categorize myself as a libertarian or a voluntarist, really. I think I'm somewhere in the middle. But I think that it's more of just I really want to study and become more knowledgeable about it. And if nothing else, just be an activist and educate people rather than actually pursue a career in the area. I mean, I'd be cool with making next to minimum wage as long as I'm out there kind of on the front lines educating people. So I think that the political science degree, if nothing, gives me some credibility.
So with college students, my experience has always been one of mostly disappointment.
Apathy.
They are not particular. Yeah, they're very apathetic. And this is not just a New Hampshire statement. This is a statement about all college students that I've ever met, including down in Florida. So apathy is huge. We tried a major outreach project on the college campus this year, running a political campaign for James Cleveland. And, I wasn't disappointed with the results. I expected to be disappointed. So, it met my expectations. But I think James probably got his hopes up a little bit more than he should have in that case. There were some college students who did turn out to vote for him. I do know that much, but there weren't enough. There weren't 100 of them. Had he gotten 100 votes from the college, he would have won.
He got 30 votes. We don't know how many of those came from the college.
Right.
I refuse to register to vote, so I'm not even, I can't even be a voter. So there you go. I would love
You're part
to
of the problem.
So, I don't know. I just don't believe in the system.
Yeah. Well, apparently you're not alone. And so, college students tend to be pretty apathetic. So I don't know what exactly, they would do ultimately to help the movement. I mean, besides coming out and meeting people and then going from there and finding out what they want. I was actually on the streets after the election here in Keene doing some cop block. And in fact, there's cop blockers around the streets tonight in the college neighborhood. But I was on the streets and this guy came up with his friends and he started asking about the liberty movement. He's like a real big Ron Paul guy, he says. And, he'd heard that there's a lot of libertarians in Keene. And he was wondering, do we all get together? Do we hang out? I said, you should come out. We've got social Sundays. It happens every Sunday. The bar that it happens at is literally right there in the college neighborhood. So it's not like you'd have to go very far to actually get to this location. Of course, nothing in Keene, New Hampshire is very far. But
you've got to walk by three other bars to get to that bar.
So this guy sounded like he was going to go. Like, I've talked to a number of college students over the years here in Keene, and this guy made me really feel like he was actually interested enough to show up to a social event. This is not actually activism. This would just be showing up to a bar and having a drink with somebody. I really thought there was a chance he might show up. Nope, he didn't show up. So, you know, that's sort of been my experience.
I've encountered that problem a lot. You know, I mean, I'm one in a million, I feel like, especially around Chicago where tons of really, really hardcore liberals. I mean, I was originally from the East Coast, but it's insane. You know, people, like, trying to educate people, and they'll talk to you like they agree with you, and then they'll walk away from the conversation. They'll come back a week later, and they have the exact same ideas as they did last week. You know, you didn't change anything.
It's frustrating. Well, of course, it takes time for people's ideas to change. But, if you're in a place like Chicago, even if you do change a few people's minds over time, it's not going to be anything more than a drop in the bucket or a drop in the ocean in the case of Chicago. We actually have Rob Mathias, who came on this show a few weeks ago as a guest host. He moved from Chicago and has really been loving it. He really has. I mean, he's been just raving about how wonderful things have been for him in New Hampshire,
especially
thus far.
Since he has a little sense of his own, what would you call that? It's not success exactly, but at least he's popular and people know about him because he has his own show.
Well, right. He's the host of the Rebel Love Show, and that's a kind of a YouTube video show at rebelloveshow.com. But he's also a doer. Like, not only is he hosting his own show, but even if he wasn't doing that, he'd be out on the streets and recording video and putting that video online. And he's been somebody who's really showcased a lot of the activism that has happened in Manchester.
And he works a full-time job.
Yeah,
so he's the claim that, you know, we can't do activism, but we have jobs, seems to be bunk when you look at what some of the people with jobs are doing.
I don't know how he finds the time to do all the activism that he does. He's amazing. I mean,
plus he has two girlfriends.
Well, that's interesting as well. I guess that's fairly popular in Manchester.
He's polygamous.
All right, so there you go,
Zach.
You should come out to, actually, if you want to meet Rob Mathias, he's going to be one of the guest speakers on Sunday at Keenevention, which is coming up in just a few weeks from now, October 31st through November 2nd. And I'm sure he'll also be hanging around the Liberty Forum early next year in March. These are great opportunities to come up to New Hampshire and check out the scene, meet some of the people that are here. Whether or not you ever get anything started on any of the college campuses here in New Hampshire, there's a huge community of liberty-minded folks living here as part of the Free State Project and New Hampshire natives as well. So it definitely will be an exciting change for you and a big change of pace in a good way, I think, from Chicago. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-453. You want to learn more about Keenevention? Go to keenevention.info. Tickets are just $60. Get you in for the entire weekend. And you'll be able to meet great activists like Rob Mathias and a number of the other names and faces that you've heard about, seen here on Free Talk Live. 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Rob's even going to be heading up a panel that we've yet to announce.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.36 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $360. Antiwar.com reports, somewhat sidelined after the Shiite Houthi rebels seized the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula has launched a pair of high-profile suicide bombings in an attempt to return to relevance. The larger of the two bombings hit the site of a planned Houthi rally in Tahrir Square, where people were just starting to arrive. At least 47 people had been confirmed killed and 75 others wounded. All of the casualties were civilians, and four of the slain were children. The second bombing took place at a Yemeni army base in the port city of Mukalla, where a suicide car bomber was followed by an attack by a gunman, killing 20 Yemeni soldiers and wounding 15 others. No reports of Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula fighter casualties apart from the suicide bombers. Though they have never been a major player in Sana'a itself, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula has broad influence across tribal regions in the nation's east as well as much of the southern coast. The Houthis, by contrast, have their power base in the northwest city of Sada'a along the ill-defined Saudi border, and after recent fighting with Sunni factions, have advanced into the capital itself.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports, frustration turned to elation Thursday as a dizzying legal wrangle ended with same-sex couples receiving marriage licenses in Las Vegas, the marriage capital of the world, and other cities across Nevada. About 10 same-sex couples were standing in line as the announcement came shortly after 5 p.m. The hopes of same-sex couples in Nevada had been in limbo since the Ninth Circuit ruled on Tuesday that same-sex couples' equal protection rights were violated by same-sex wedding bans in Nevada and Idaho. The last challenge opposing Nevada's same-sex marriage was dropped early Thursday, and the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals again declared that its ruling allowed same-sex couples to marry in the state and said it was in full force and effect. Clerks waited for a trial judge to enforce the court's order before they started issuing licenses around 5 p.m. on Thursday. Not long after, Clark County Clerk Diana Alba apologized to about five same-sex couples waiting at the Las Vegas Marriage License Bureau. Meanwhile, same-sex couples in West Virginia began receiving marriage licenses after the state's attorney general dropped his fight opposing same-sex unions. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports the St. Louis area on Thursday was bracing for more unrest over the August killing of Michael Brown by a police officer, and another police killing of a teen on Wednesday was expected to add fuel to the fire. Several civil rights organizations and protest groups, including Hands Up United, planned to mark the weekend with marches and rallies in St. Louis and the suburb of Ferguson, where Brown was killed 2 months ago. The groups are demanding the arrest of the police officer who killed Brown, and they want to to draw attention to police treatment of Black Americans. Protest organizers said they are planning only peaceful activities, but fear that Wednesday's killing of a Black teenager in the South St. Louis neighborhood of Shaw might trigger a violent outburst. Tori Russell, the leader of Hands Up United, said, "We never advocate violence, but I do know that people were angry last night and they will be out this weekend. I don't know what they're going to do." At least 6,000 people have registered on an organizing website for the weekend of resistance events in and around Ferguson. Organizers said they are planning to create a memory altar to victims of police violence and to hold a candlelight march carrying a coffin to the Ferguson Police Department. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. A family of five is found alive in the suburbs. This is Doyle Redland reporting. The Holzapfel family, long feared missing or spiritually dead, was found alive in the Chicago suburb of Buffalo Grove today, somehow managing to survive in the hostile environment for more than 8 years. Rescuers discovered the five-person clan after a survey plane spotted a signal fire from a barbecue grill. To protect themselves from the elements during their long ordeal, the Holzapfels fashioned a three-bedroom ranch-style lean-to with brick facing and white aluminum siding. Paramedic Mary Gills was first on the scene.
They were all suffering from severe cultural malnutrition.
The Holzapfels have been returned to civilization for now, though trips to the Art Institute of Chicago and a nice Peruvian restaurant intended to reacquaint them with urban living have been met with confusion and resistance. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. Just dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, Ellen has more on the Adam Carolla lawsuit that we thought was settled and done with. There's an update on apparently some similar lawsuits that we didn't even know about, or at least I didn't. So she's going to give us that here in a little bit. Your calls and thoughts are welcome, 855-450-FREE. We're also focusing quite a bit tonight on North Korea and just the fascinating the political intrigue going on over there. Now, ultimately, we really don't know what's happening because, well, nobody really gets out of North Korea on any regular basis to tell anyone what's happening.
Right, there. And based on, you know, the article from Vice that I read earlier, a lot of people in North Korea don't really know what's happening in North Korea.
Yeah, you pretty much have to be one of the political elite to have any clue what's going on in that country. Any news that comes out of North Korea is either just rumor or it comes from the official North Korean news agency, which is run by the state. So, of course, it's not trustworthy. However, the story from Vice here that I have, and there was one that you shared with us earlier, Daryl, that sort of speculated that Kim Jong-un is, in point of fact, not in control of North Korea. This story goes over that, and it points to the Organization and Guidance Department, the OGD, which is a group of officials that reported at one time to Kim Jong-il, who was Kim Jong-un's father, who passed away. Kim Jong-un, of course, the chubby boy who took the reins of power there, which, of course, nobody really trusts him. They don't know anything about him, and he doesn't have the same level of political capital that his father and grandfather did. So really, it seemed like it was only a matter of time before he lost his power, whether because he died or, in this case, that there was some sort of a military junta.
A coup sort of thing.
Took control through what is ostensibly a bloodless coup thus far.
Although, so, I would not say that it's completely bloodless.
Well, because his uncle's dead.
Right. His uncle was executed for, you know, like some form of treason type something.
Well, they made it look like in the media that it was Kim Jong-un who had ordered that execution. But the suggestion is that, in point of fact, he didn't.
Right. That's the speculation. And, you know, based on what I've been able to read, that was sort of the symbol that was being presented by the OGD of, hey, look, the Kim family's not in charge anymore. Here's one of their, you know, cousins, brother, uncle, whatever.
Okay, but the way their country is run, Kim Jong-il and his father, they were
rulers, and he doesn't have an heir yet. He doesn't have somebody that's going to follow up after he's gone. Maybe he was taking out his uncle so that there was no competition.
It's possible. Anything's possible. But I you know, as far as what speculation we should trust here, it makes sense to believe a man who was formerly a high-ranking propaganda machine officer. This guy is Jang Jin-sung. He was the closing speaker at a conference that happened this year in September with a group of elite exiles, people who were in the high ranks of government in North Korea who have since escaped the country and are now speaking out about what was going on there. If anybody's going to be someone worth trusting as far as their speculation, this guy is pretty decent at it. So there's a little bit more here about Kim Jong-un and, you know, what's going on? Why has he disappeared from public view? Because apparently, you know, like a month ago, the last time he was seen, he had not presided over the Supreme People's Assembly, which is a rubber stamp parliament. He missed that meeting, was replaced by a propaganda video that showed him limping. The video's narrator said, "Despite some discomfort, our marshal continues to come out and lead the people," showing him limping. And he's still out there. He's tough. He's, you know, like the country. He's on a comeback. Rumors abound about the cause of his absence, including a report from South Korea's Chosun Ilbo that he recently underwent surgery after fracturing both of his ankles, quote, during a grueling tour of military bases and factories in Cuban heels, unquote. The South Korean news agency Yonhap cited anonymous sources saying that Kim, a heavy smoker who has become markedly plump since assuming the role of dictator, is suffering from gout along with hyperuricemia, hyperlipidemia, obesity, diabetes, and high blood pressure.
Ooh, quite a list.
But whatever the cause, Kim Jong-un's absence has sparked another round of speculation about the stability of the North Korean regime and what will happen to the country if the young dictator dies or becomes deposed. Rumors of a coup spread quickly earlier this week on Weibo, which is China's version of Twitter, followed by a stern denial from China, the regime's chief ally. A U.S. State Department spokeswoman told reporters on Monday that the coup reports are unconfirmed. But Jang, however, the former high-level propaganda minister, he says that the coup happened in 2013 and that Kim Jong-un is just a puppet with the officials from the OGD actually pulling the strings. After going into exile, Jang became a senior research fellow at the Institute for National Security Strategy in Seoul and authored a memoir entitled Dear Leader, about his time serving Kim Jong-il. Jang's also the founder and publisher of New Focus International, an independent outlet for North Korean news and analysis. Combined with his knowledge of the inner workings of North Korean bureaucracy, Jang says he maintains contact with sources inside the regime that provide him with current information. Now, that's very interesting. He says that it was the coup that coincided with the execution of Jang Sung-taek, which was Kim Jong's uncle by marriage, a longtime political rival of the OGD, but considered untouchable because of his family ties to Kim Jong-il. Jang Sung-taek was officially charged with, quote, consolidating his own power with factional maneuvering, unquote, and selling off state resources at below market value for personal profit. He was summarily purged last December, and a popular but apparently false rumor had him being eaten alive by dogs. I remember we heard about that claim on Free Talk Live.
So what he's doing here, it sounds like something that any corrupt politician would do, you know, sell off goods at below market value for personal gains. But, you know, I still stick to my claim from earlier. I think maybe, you know, the fact that he was a political contender made him a threat.
You mean he was a threat to Kim Jong-un?
Yes.
Well, they're saying here, the former propaganda minister is saying that in point of fact, he was contrary to the OGD. And if the OGD had taken control of power, then this would be a way of them showing that no one is safe. That they can't execute Kim Jong-un, of course, because he's a figurehead.
But his uncle through marriage.
The next best thing would be his uncle. He doesn't have any other family. I mean, his dad's dead.
All right, but
well,
who did he marry? Who did he marry that was actually related?
I don't know.
He must have somebody who's related to him.
So Kim Jong-il has multiple brothers? Or has multiple sons? It figures.
Yes. Yeah, I'm actually looking through the Wikipedia articles of all of the brothers. He's got a sister that was mentioned earlier as now she might be the figurehead. One of the brothers, actually the oldest brother of Kim Jong-un, is Kim Jong-nam. And he was, for a long time, considered to be the heir apparent, but he went into exile and is now a critic of the family regime and an advocate for reform.
Oh, wow.
And I'm trying to read up on some of the others to where I wonder,
why was Kim Jong-un chosen over all of the other options?
Probably because he was like, what a sweet gig. I get to have all the power and all the things. And
maybe he was the most obedient of all the sons.
I mean,
possibly.
If he really is a political puppet, as this article says, which is very believable, I'm sure he has many advisors that actually know what's going on with the country, and he's just the figurehead going out and giving speeches on television. But, you know, maybe he was just the most well-trained of all.
Jang predicts the North Korean regime will collapse in the coming years due to divisions between older elites and a younger generation that's benefiting from the growth of private markets in North Korea. While the regime once maintained rigid control over the North Korean economy and food supply, today people trade goods and services in public markets that are still technically illegal but widely tolerated. So we've heard about these black markets in North Korea where, because if it weren't for these black markets, like sort of in happened in the Soviet Union in the past, people would starve to death.
The middle son of Kim Jong-il was passed over because his father thought he was no good and acted like a little girl.
More coming up.
Is gun ownership about target shooting, hunting, and self-defense, or is there more to it? Oath Keepers and Rayburn Entertainment present Molon Labe, inspired by the works of Edwin Vieira Jr., explains why we need to revitalize the state militia system. Featuring Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, Larry Pratt, and Stuart Rhodes. Available on DVD at moviepubs.net, oathkeepers.org, and gunowners.org.
Talk radio generally and Free Talk Live specifically are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the Tort Attorneys right now. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. 800-708-7917. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want. Just dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. Skype in at username lrn.fm. Talking about the transition of power, suspected transition of power in North Korea to from Kim Jong-un without his consent to the OGD, which is also known as the Organization and Guidance Department, a powerful group of officials that once reported to Kim Jong-un's dad, Kim Jong-il. They say, or the speculation here of some exiles, some elite exiles, people who were in positions of power, including one propaganda minister, a key member of the propaganda machine from North Korea. They're saying that the OGD has taken control and has had that control ever since Kim Jong-un's uncle was executed many months ago. We can continue the discussion here and also get an update on the podcast lawsuits. FreedomsPhoenix.com gives you the secrets and exposes the lies. They're uncovering the secrets there over at FreedomsPhoenix.com, and you'll be provided the real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments at FreedomsPhoenix.com. There's up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com and sign up for the free daily dispatch. Again, that's FreedomsPhoenix.com. So, once again, 855-450-FREE, more on North Korea. The power, they say, in North Korea really resides in the OGD, and Jang predicts the North Korean regime is going to collapse due to divisions between older elites and the younger generation benefiting from the growth of private markets. We had heard about the black markets in North Korea before, and apparently they are now tolerated by the government in North Korea. They're technically illegal, but they're allowed to exist because that's the way people get fed. You can't count on the government to take care of people, otherwise you get mass starvation, which of course North Korea suffered through, I think, as recently as the 1990s.
So of course when they say black market, are they talking about farmers who decide to take their goods to their neighbor and be like, hey, I'll trade you this corn for whatever, like, you know, maybe it's like chickens they have over there.
There's so actual marketplaces, from what I understand, where people are doing business.
Okay, so it's just any bartering that's outside of government control.
Exactly.
Is illegal.
And that same sort of thing happened in the former Soviet Union.
It had to. It had to, because once the government takes control of distribution of food, shortages become a real problem, and then you get bread lines and starvation and things
like that.
Right, in
Russia, under Stalin's rule, more people died of starvation than... I don't know. Like, that's a huge number of people.
Right. And there was even the quote in the Soviet Union at the time, if Stalin only knew, because the people thought that Stalin was this benevolent dictator that had no clue that things weren't being handled properly.
Well, obviously, they're the ones that didn't have any clue because his advisors changed every few months.
From being executed?
Yes.
Yeah. Matthew Reichel, founder of the Pyongyang Project, a group that organizes study tours of North Korea for foreigners, has traveled extensively throughout the country and recently returned from a month-long trip to Pyongyang, Chongjin, Hamhung, and other cities in the country's north. He says these markets are thriving. It's not anything particularly new, it's just something that's growing in size, he told Vice News. You can go into a market in Pyongyang or Chongjin or any city and get things you'd use every day. Basically anything you'd find in the North Korean version of Walmart. Reichel said he observed people wearing fashions from South Korea and China, indicating they have access to forms of foreign media that were once banned. In fact, there was the recent, I think it's called the Secret State of North Korea documentary that PBS put together, where they follow a smuggler on his path from South Korea to North Korea, where it's a North Korean soldier, a guard who actually is assisting in the smuggling, sort of following the path of this smuggler. And what is he smuggling in? He's smuggling in flash drives.
I've heard of this.
South Korean and American television shows and movies on them. So people in North Korea, obviously very hungry for any kind of entertainment that's not produced by the state. And this is an illegal thing to do. And this is, very, very underground, very hush-hush kind of stuff. But apparently they're even smuggling in fashion and things like that. Some government
that wouldn't be obvious.
What if their new fashion showing up?
Yeah, if you're wearing something that's not traditionally North Korean, mm-hmm. that's going to be quite obvious to be caught in.
The fact that they're getting away with it now really shows that the government's turning a blind eye to it, though. Some government officials view the new freedoms as a threat to their power, but cracking down is a risky move that could lead to total collapse of the economy and a repeat of the famine in the mid-90s that led thousands of people to starve to death. Reichel said, quote, because the public distribution system has utterly failed, they've lost so much control of the country. When they can't control the economy, this is in essence a loss of control of the country. And it's been that way since the end of the famine, and it's not going to reverse itself. Others argue the burgeoning market economy doesn't necessarily spell writing on the wall for the North Korean regime. Chad O'Carroll, director of NK News, a Seoul-based North Korea news source, said similar arrangements already exist in Iran, Zimbabwe, and other authoritarian dictatorships. He says it gives them less control than it used to, that's certain, but because that's happening doesn't mean it's going to collapse. I don't necessarily buy this argument that it's going to lead to an imminent collapse. Jay Ulfeder, an independent political consultant who studies democratization, coup d'etats, and state collapse, says the conditions in North Korea don't seem ripe for the sort of popular uprising that typically forces totalitarian regimes to cede power. China's role in the situation is also key because North Korea is so heavily dependent on them economically. He said, I get the impression that China's pretty committed to playing that role to sustain a friendly regime on its border as a buffer against South Korea and the United States. From their perspective, the loyalty and stability are far more beneficial than any sort of minor gains that might accrue from having a somewhat wealthier or more liberalized North Korea. He noted that it's in the self-interest of the exiled elites to play up the possibility of regime collapse in North Korea, and pointed out that pundits have been saying for years that the country is on the verge of upheaval. He pointed to analysis he wrote in 2012 for Foreign Policy, which stated that, quote, waiting for North Korea to crack open is like waiting for the Cubs to win the World Series, and no amount of wishing makes it so. The fact that the regime possesses nuclear weapons and has seemingly no regard for human life makes foreign military intervention highly unlikely. The UN in February released a report documenting widespread human rights abuses in the country's prison camps, and U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry called for the evil system to be shut down. Brooker said the threat of being hauled before the International Court of Justice over prison camp atrocities frightens many of North Korea's ruling elites. But other experts say it's only a matter of time until feuding among the elites or popular discontent, or perhaps a combination of the two, leads to dramatic changes in the North Korean political landscape. And when I heard this idea that the OGD was now in charge, and that's just the allegation, we don't know if it's true, but if this group of elites is now in charge, it'll be hard for these guys to stay as a group in charge. Imagine that they would want to be, all of them would want to be the new dear leader. They would want to have that level of power, but they would all be fighting over it.
Right, and slowly, one by one, they might, fall to the wayside, just mysteriously disappear.
But none of them would have the legitimacy of dear leader because none of them are related to Kim.
But
Dear
did the
Leader.
Original Dear Leader have legitimacy when he started?
He decreed himself Dear Leader
exactly.
and scared people into worshiping him.
We'll come back with more. 855-450-FREE. Your thoughts are welcome on North Korea or anything.
Hi, I'm John Rainey, Chief Financial Officer of United Airlines, and I'm honored to be the National Chair for the 2015 March for Babies campaign for the March of Dimes. United is a proud supporter of the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Please join us in working together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit marchofdimes.org.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Take control of the airwaves toll-free at 855-450-FREE as we talk about possible regime change in North Korea. Is it happening or has it already gone down with Kim Jong-un disappearing from public view for several weeks now? There's a lot of questions as to what that really means. We can continue with a little bit more speculation from Vice.com. Having talked to a number of purported experts on the subject, there's some disagreement on whether or not the North Korean government will fall apart in the coming months or weeks or whenever. Time will tell, and we'll certainly continue to follow it as closely as we can, given as disconnected as we are from it. Of course, so is everyone else in the world, because North Korea is a very secretive place where information does not flow freely at all. We can continue that discussion, and also want to let you know about an upcoming conference, Hack the Trackers. Is privacy dead? Not if you have anything to say about it. On November 7th and 8th, coders, privacy specialists, and idea people of all stripes will join together for Hack the Trackers, a transparency and privacy hackathon brought to you by Ghostery. You can enter online or join them in person in New York City to create tools that make the web a more transparent place or help users manage how much data they share. The hacks will be judged by experts and voted on by an online community, and winners will receive a prize package including the all-new Black Phone, a secure-by-design smartphone for people who recognize a need for privacy and want a simple, secure place to start. Participation is free, and registration is open now. Visit hackthetrackers.com for more information. Again, that's hackthetrackers.com. So a little bit more here from North Korea, where some experts say it's only a matter of time between or before feuding among the elites or popular discontent or a combo of the two leads to dramatic changes on the North Korean political landscape. Victor Cha, the former director for Asian Affairs in the White House's National Security Council and the director of the Asian Studies Program at Georgetown University, compared the country's political situation to a house of cards that's only being held up by the presence of Kim Jong-un. He says if we look at the North Korea situation objectively speaking, obviously all the indicators for collapse are there in the sense of uncertain leadership, weak economy, and all these things are indicators that the regime is having trouble. The only thing I think we're missing right now is the trigger. Jang, meanwhile, that's the exiled propaganda minister, believes the OGD's grip on power is so strong that Kim Jong-un could be replaced by either of his elder brothers, Kim Jong-nam and Kim Jong-chul, as figurehead, and business would continue as usual. He also suggested that Kim's absence at the Supreme People's Assembly and withdrawal from public view has actually been scripted by the regime's propaganda ministry. Jang said divisions between adult children, and remember, he used to work for the propaganda ministry, said divisions between adult children of North Korea's elites and the conservative old guard pose the most serious threat to the regime's long-term stability. He says all of the OGD kids, basically anyone who has a trade or business rights, they're all sons and daughters of the powerful elite. Because of that situation, because of economic trade, there's no order you can enforce. Business by nature is competitive. And within that, there will be policy disagreements, trade feuds, and bickering. And that's why it's not going to stay this unified system. It's extremely difficult, says Vice, to gauge the impact that regime change would have on the average North Korean citizen.
I don't know. I think that it is possible that it would wind up staying a unified system. And the only reason that I think that is look at all of the various cartels that one would think would be at each other's throats that unify for certain purposes.
Like what?
Well, for instance, it's the drug cartels that are among the most adamant against legalizing cannabis or, you know, other substances.
But so if you're so desperate,
they actually wind up working with people that you would think they would not want to work with to protect their own interest.
Right, but if they're so desperate to get goods into the country, would it not benefit them to not be cutthroat? Like, wouldn't they want to work together with these other black
markets? All of the elites would want to work together to sort of, you know, maintain a power group.
Yeah, but if they can make more money by having
but
things...
But they don't understand competition.
Maybe like, they do.
They do now, because there is competition. There's competition in these black markets. But the thing is, when you've got a black market in the United States, it's not the entire market, right? So the black market in the United States only exists in gambling and prostitution and, you know, drugs and things that are prohibited. So you've got all this other economic activity that can feed billions of dollars into that black market. So being in the black market in the United States is a very it's a lucrative activity. Whereas if the black market is the entirety of the country, then you're still not, you know, you don't have exactly a whole bunch of money chasing around all these goods. There's not a lot of wealth there to begin with. So I don't think that you can really, I think that's not really comparing apples to apples. You know, what I'm saying is that if you're a black marketeer in North Korea, it's not like you're raking in the dough like you would be in the United States.
Right.
So you would have an interest if you were running the black market, or if you were, you know, operating some sort of trade or business, you would have an interest in seeing that deregulated, I would think, simply because open air business would be more profitable in the long run.
In theory, but it's one of those things of, do they really understand the economics of competition is good?
If you're talking about the elites, then they must know by, you know, looking at other countries, even from an outside comparison, even with their limited knowledge, they must see that their country is not doing nearly as well fiscally as other countries. And what makes that difference? And it's the black market. Or in, you know, most other countries' cases, it's just the free market.
There's a greater fear in Pyongyang of collapse and what destabilization would mean, says Reichel. There's a concern that even developing the economy should be gradual because nobody wants anything that could be catastrophic. As for Kim's recent absence, it's not the first time since the Supreme Leader has gone missing. He was out of public view for a separate three-week periods in March and June of 2012, and then went 18 days without a public appearance in January 2013. Asked to speculate about the state of the dictator's health and what it could mean, the former propaganda minister replied that outsiders focus too much on the actions of Kim Jong-un, ignoring the real power brokers who control the government behind the scenes. He says, basically, the outside world's been brainwashed by Kim Jong-il's dictatorship. They're all thinking along the lines of what they're being given by the propaganda, but that's not what's really going on. We'll continue with more. We've got Jim calling in North Korea. You're on Free Talk Live. Jim.
It's Reverend Jim.
Oh, you're not calling from North Korea. I'm sorry. I misread the call screening software.
No, I had a question. Right. I had a question about North Korea for Ellen, but I first like to say that, like Fidel Castro, the murderers in the Jong family for the last 50 years doesn't care at all about the misfortunates that their worship, the misfortunates, pure worship of their cult of personality is recompense enough for the poverty of the people that they love to rule over. But anyway, I was wondering about the haves and haves not, speaking of course of Korean Peninsula, Ellen, and might you have any clue as to why one country is black at night and the other one is light at night, and one is really has a great wealth of nations and the other has nothing?
Thanks for the call tonight, Jim. Appreciate it. I think the answer is pretty obvious, but the question was for you. Ellen, go ahead.
Well, yes. I mean, obviously, if a country is dark at night, that is a strong indication that they don't have nearly as much, they don't have enough wealth to power an electrical system, something like what you would see if you're over the U.S. at night. You'd mm-hmm. see all these vast cities lit up, especially if you're on the space station. And, you know, the denser an area is, the more lights you can see. And even like if you're flying in an airplane, you can see just flying over even the smallest of cities or any light that you see on the ground. That's an indication that there's somebody living there that's working, that's making a living, that can afford to pay for the service that the electrical company provides, which is they produce electricity and they sell it to you.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. In North Korea, they don't have power. I mean, it's very hard to provide power in a place where there's no real economic incentive to do it.
And who can afford it?
And plus, there's also a propaganda line that goes along with it. I forget which documentary I was watching, but they showed the explanation for the constant power outages there.
And many restrictions on the production of it.
They say that it's the United States that's attacking them.
Yes.
And that's why the power is going out constantly. More coming up. This is Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellawood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellawood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellawood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance. All with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest to you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. Enough time for you with your calls and thoughts. Just dial in at 855-450-FREE. Joining you in the studio, Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
We continue and go right back into your calls. Don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com and join us there for all the features that we give away to you. You can also, I haven't mentioned this very often, but we do have a YouTube channel where the video footage from each show is posted pretty much every night. We didn't record during the most recent Bitcoin conference because we didn't have a camera there. But
when we're in studio, yeah, it's being recorded as long as night. Ian remembers to press start.
Yeah, yeah. And which is most nights. And so that means you can watch that for free if that's what you want to do over at youtube.freetalklive.com. We'll take you right to it. We've got Alma on the line in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live, Alma.
Hey, sweetie pie.
Hey, Alma.
All right.
Y'all pretty smart people. I've listened to you enough.
Thank you.
Me and my son have discussed this many a times. Can't discuss it with other radio shows around here. But student loan debtors, what do you think that the government's going to do with these kids that can't pay off the college loans? We have our ideas. I'd like to hear an idea from you.
Well, are you asking what will they do or what do we think they should do?
Think. Yeah, think. Because we don't know what they will do. Think they will do.
Most likely they will continue charging interest, and because people can't make the payments, people will go into default and then pretty much never pay back the loans. And then, you know, 20, 30 years down the road, they'll wind up owing 5-6 times more in, you know, loan and interest than what it was that they pulled out.
Okay, but this is kind of an interesting question.
I know people who have been making the minimum payments on their student loans for years and still wind up owing more than what they took out.
Right.
Yes, you're stupid. Give it to me, lady.
So I'm just wondering, because I'm thinking maybe 20 or 30 years down the road, when, you know, things have changed, and I'm just going to guess, seeing as the snowball is already tumbling down the mountainside, that things in America are going to be worse than they are now. And maybe if a student owes a debt to the government can say, well, in order to pay off this debt, you now have to serve us for this amount of time.
There you go.
So maybe, you know, they would demand military service or something like that.
That's what we said. You're going to go into the military, or you're going to do what they want you to do to pay them back.
That's a scary idea. Thanks, Alma, for your call tonight. Robert's in Florida as well. Robert, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Robert.
Alan, sweetie, you wish the U.S. military is the difference between North and South Korea.
All right, you can only call once per night, and that is the rule here on Free Talk Live. That was Jim calling from Arizona, who just called a moment ago. Let's go to Sergey calling from Russia via Skype. Sergey, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hello, guys. Can you hear me okay?
Hey, yes.
Yeah, great. Hi. Yeah, right. I'm calling you from Russia. My name is Sergey. And as much as I was enjoying your discussion about North Korea and student loans, I have another, I think, extremely important issue to discuss, and that is your new bumper music. Is that okay with you?
Sure, if you would like. We discussed it to an extent last night at the very end of the show, but go ahead.
Yeah, I know. Basically, as I understand, you've just changed your bumper music, and there are some people who may be less than perfectly happy about it, from what I understand, because
which is to be expected.
They're used to the old music, and they say, hey, we don't like this new music.
You did something different.
Yeah,
exactly. Basically, I just wanted to call in and say that I do like your new bumper music.
Oh, thanks.
And that I think it's a lot better than what it used to be. I'm not a fan of very heavy and loud music, and I think it was a bit too loud, too noisy, too aggressive, and I would even go so far as to say even incompatible with the ideas of freedom. So I think it's a welcome
improvement. I'd say that's a stretch, but I'm glad your
music's a bit more professional now.
I'm glad that someone appreciates the change. You're the first positive feedback that we've received.
Yeah, I just felt compelled to call you today and say that I do like it, unlike other people who are apparently upset about it. So I'm actually pretty sure that your the number of your affiliate radio stations will go up to at least 500. in less than a month, because it's such a welcome change.
Optimistic.
I appreciate that. Well,
thank you, Sergey. Anything else you want to comment on tonight?
No. I just wanted to say that I really like your show. I've been listening to you guys for years now, I think, and I'm possibly your most dedicated listener in Russia.
What time is it where you are in Russia right now?
In Russia right now, it's 7:50.
In the morning.
A.M. Yeah.
Waking up with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Exactly. I just felt that I need to get up today early.
Did you stay up or you get up?
No, I got up early, okay, like maybe 20 minutes ago, and I felt like I need to call and tell you something positive.
Wow, an early bird.
I felt that, yeah. Not normally, but today I just decided, hey, why not?
Thanks, Sergey. I appreciate the call tonight.
Great show. Thank you very much. Yes. Yeah.
Thanks for the call this morning, I guess. I appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here tonight. I love international calls, and Skype makes it so easy. Nathan's in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Nathan.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, go ahead.
Well, I actually think the new the old music was very compatible with freedom. It, you know, it had this really, you know, strong metal feel to it that really goes with your personality, I thought.
Really rebellious.
So I'm going to miss it.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to miss that a lot.
All right. Anything else you were calling about tonight?
Well, on the student, on the college thing, I thought the obvious reason for, which, because you were talking about college students, you know, not being interested in doing activism, two things occurred to me immediately, and then I thought of a third one. You know, they don't pay taxes or a lot of it, and they don't have a lot of money, so they may not really appreciate the burden of state action very much.
I don't have a lot of money, but I still do what I do.
Right. It's more about seeing injustices and relating with them than it is about, you know, actually having it. Like, you may not suffer from, you know, being thrown in jail for a nonviolent crime, but you can still feel for somebody who has been.
Well, that's certainly true. It just seems, I kind of agree with Ian that that's the way it is. And the other thing I thought of is, you know, if they do activism, then their, you know, parents probably won't be happy about bailing them out of jail and paying for their college, which I guess is kind of a restatement of the first thing. So,
but there's a bunch of safe activism to do. So, sure. You know, like standing on a sidewalk holding a sign is safe activism.
Most
chances are you're not getting arrested for that.
In Keene, you'd probably be all right. Yeah.
Most places in the country, you're going to be okay.
They threatened James Babb the other day outside of Philadelphia at a courthouse. Now, they didn't arrest him, because that's because, you know, he knew what he was doing and stood up for himself. So they might threaten you.
Well, the last possibility I thought of would be that, you know, since they're sort of closer to the indoctrination system than we are. So, you know, that means that. Well, it's not like they're more sheeple or whatever than the average person, but they're still in that system of that government school system, you know, that teaches conformity and obedience to authority and such. So maybe it's harder for them to break out of that.
Or maybe it's just that people in general are apathetic and college students aren't any different from people in general. That could be a factor. Nathan, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. So, Ellen, what's the latest? The Adam Carolla case got thrown out. They came to an agreement. The patent troll had gone after Adam Carolla because he was one of the more popular podcasters out there, trying to shut him down, trying to get a big payout. Ultimately, they agreed to drop the case. But there's more to the story?
Yes. So Personal Audio, which is a company that supposedly patented the idea for podcasting in 1996 and 2000, they came after several really big companies like Amazon, Samsung, Apple, and they also went after a few other podcasts like How Stuff Works, and Adam Carolla happened to be one of them. And, you know, they were just doing this because they thought they could get money out of it, which they actually did, which I have an article about how they won $1.3 million in damages from CBS. But now they're finally able to, Adam Carolla and his company, they're finally able to talk about the case now because the vow of silence, the date has passed. So now it's legal for them technically. And I was listening to the show on the way here, actually.
And what did you learn in less than 30 seconds?
So Personal Audio, they were trying to get money out of Adam Carolla. They found that they couldn't because he was able to keep up with his fines for, you know, crowdsourcing the legal fees. Mm-hmm. And they basically said, well, we will drop the case now, but that doesn't guarantee that we won't sue you in the future.
In the future.
Yep, as long as you be quiet about it.
Wow. All right, we'll see you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com.
Do you...
Americans across the nation made their voices heard this week as they demanded more mind-blowing guitar solos. Calling for the solos to be, quote, face-meltingly cool and go on for well over 10 minutes, Americans stressed that all guitar solos from now on should be equally as kick-ass as those in Van Halen's Hot for Teacher and AC/DC's Thunderstruck, or even better.
It should start out really slow, you know, and then get faster and faster until they're all the way up at the top of the guitar neck and bending the notes like crazy. So it's like, and then there's all this awesome pyrotechnic stuff going off in the background. They should all be like that.
And in this week's local news, a report noted that on its surface, Glenbrook, Ohio is a small town like any other, a peaceful, all-American town. And yet, the report's authors added, if you only look closer, what you find may surprise you. In other news, a man is just having one of those decades where he doesn't feel like doing anything.
This is the Onion News Network.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.36 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $360. Antiwar.com reports, somewhat sidelined after the Shiite Houthi rebels seized the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula has launched a pair of high-profile suicide bombings in an attempt to return to relevance. The larger of the two bombings hit the site of a planned Houthi rally in Tahrir Square, where people were just starting to arrive. At least 47 people had been confirmed killed and 75 others wounded. All of the casualties were civilians, and four of the slain were children. The second bombing took place at a Yemeni army base in the port city of Mukalla, where a suicide car bomber was followed by an attack by a gunman, killing 20 Yemeni soldiers and wounding 15 others. No reports of Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula fighter casualties apart from the suicide bombers. Though they have never been a major player in Sana'a itself, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula has broad influence across tribal regions in the nation's east as well as much of the southern coast. The Houthis, by contrast, have their power base in the northwest city of Sada'a along the ill-defined Saudi border, and after recent fighting with Sunni factions, have advanced into the capital itself. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust